Hi, yogis. My name is Kristi. Welcome to your full body yin yoga class. This class, we will be diving into the sensation of deep surrender and letting go. And part of manifestation, two big parts, is the first part is really feeling that abundance mindset and empowered mindset. The second part of manifestation is letting go and being okay with what is what is, right? So allowing ourselves to feel like we're being supported by the universe, God, spirit, whatever you resonate with, and allowing ourselves to surrender into all the pivots, all the lessons that come our way, even when that sometimes doesn't feel easy. It can feel difficult, but remember that stimulates growth. So no other way to embody the feeling of surrender than in a really deep, juicy yin yoga practice. So the first posture or shape we're going to move into in yin, this is called caterpillar pose, and it's a deep forward fold. And before we begin, you can, if you have these at home, to get pretty comfortable in these postures, you can use blocks. I recommend having two yoga blocks, and you can always use books if you don't have blocks. A bolster. If you do not have a bolster, no worries. Just use your bed pillow, and you can even wrap a blanket around it, or couch pillows work well too. And then you can also have either one or two blankets. So we're going to get started in our first shape, our forward fold, our caterpillar pose. And I will be showing you all different options, so whether you have props or not. The first variation would be to bring a bolster underneath, or a pillow underneath the backs of your knees. And if you know that you have low back pain, if you have an injury in your spine or your neck, this is a really good option to take the force off the low back. And then you'll just simply start to round forward. And with yin, it's always nice to bring props underneath to support the head if you like. The second option, if you want to not use the bolster, you can always use a blanket, so it's a little lower underneath the backs of the knees. And just round forward, so your chin is rounding in towards your chest. Let the arms slide back, some palms face up either next to your thighs or on top of the thighs. And we're going to be here for quite some time. We find this beautiful first principle of yin, which is called finding our edge. So it's kind of this middle place of feeling too much sensation, like we're pushing or forcing. And on the other end of the spectrum, not feeling any sensation. Just finding that middle ground. And once you find the spot, just hold, surrender, let go. Allow the muscles to relax. And then the third principle is holding for time. So I'll be keeping track of the time here on my phone. So you can just close your eyes and drop in. Take a few deep breaths. Just allow the shoulder blades to slide apart. You can continually allow that chin to move in the direction towards your chest. Rounding the back of the neck. Letting the navel relax down and forward towards the thighs. At any point in this forward fold, if your head is not supported, You can always lift the head very gently. We always want to be slow in our movements and maybe circle it out and then come back into your fold or bring some support underneath the forehead. And in yin, this is such a powerful practice because we're not bypassing any emotions or feelings. We're leaning into those. So maybe you've been caught in a cycle lately of trying to control and force and push. And that can only lead to exhaustion, sometimes burnout. So as you just let go in this deep flexion of the spine, see if you can embody that sensation of surrender, of aligning with the concept of co-conspiring with the universe. That there's this cosmic force so much greater than ourselves that is aligning us. And everything is happening exactly the way it should. At any point, if your body starts to open, you can lean into another layer, releasing tension as your body maybe drops even an inch closer to your thighs. If you want to take away props or add props, always coming from a place of nurturing and supporting the body. As your body starts to drop deeper into these yin shapes, see if you can deepen your breath as well. Maybe breathing in for the count of 4, 3, 2, 1, and open the mouth and exhale. Or 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slow breath in. Slow, deep exhale out. We have the last minute here in caterpillar pose. Find your edge, deepest layer of the posture. And that could be staying exactly as you are.
Again, to turn your palms face down. Maybe slide them into the center between your thighs. And walk your hands back towards your thighs, lifting the head very slowly. The head is last to come up.
Coming up to an upright position, just rest your palms on top of your thighs. Close your eyes. Take a full deep breath in. Deep breath out. Just let your body adjust slowly to coming upright. And then bring your hands over your heart space. Take some deep breaths. And repeat, I trust the universe always has my back. I trust the universe always has my back. Everything is unfolding exactly as it should. Everything is unfolding exactly as it should. And then release your hands. And we'll slowly make our way onto hands and knees. And you can bring, if you would like, either fold up your mat and bring it across underneath your knees, or I always like to use a blanket across the mat. And just find some linear cat-cows after that deep forward fold. So let the belly drop down, maybe lift the shoulder blades. You can keep the gaze directly forward or down. And then spread your fingertips, press the mat away, and lift the back of your heart towards the ceiling. You can tuck your toes or relax your feet and close your eyes and just do a few of these undulations in the spine. And then from there, just let the hips sway a little bit side to side, finding just some somatic movements to move energy, to move stuck energy, stress, tension. You can rock back and forth. Beautiful. And then let's come into child's pose. Bring your knees out wide, big toes to touch. And you can sink your hips back towards your heels. You may need a bolster between the thighs. If it's difficult for you to reach your hips towards your heels, you can straddle your bolster and then maybe bring a block underneath the forehead. For a more restorative variation, you can bring a block underneath the bolster and just come up lying on top here. Or if you have your favorite variation of child's pose, you can just rest either your forehead to the mat or a block. And then just allow your elbows to slightly bend here, maybe even stacking the palms, resting your forehead there. And then we hold for time, allowing the body to deeply compress those channels of energy along the inner thighs, backs of the calves. See if you can find those deep belly breaths, long inhales and even longer exhales.
your mind starts to wander off your mat, just gently bring it back. The easiest way to stay present is just connect to your breath and connect to the sensations you're feeling in your body. If you're connected to your breath and your mind is still wandering, just attach it to the mantra, every inhale, let, and every exhale, go. Inhale, let. Exhale, go. Gently begin to lift your head first. See if you can slide your hands underneath the shoulders. And then walk your hands back. Just bring one knee in at a time. You may need to remove your props and come forward and find some movement in the hips. That should feel pretty good to open and release after all of that compression. Feeling any of that energy moving through the fronts of the hips, inner thighs, maybe even down into the feet. Remembering in yin that these transitions and rebounds between our poses are an important part of the practice. So they allow us to really initiate that synovial fluid release and also bring hydration into the joints. So now we're going to move into a heart opener. So classic heart opener, Anahatasana, or melting heart pose. So I will show you different variations here. The first variation, this is my favorite, is to bring a pillow or the bolster across the mat horizontally. Knees are on the blanket. And you keep your knees underneath your hip joints. And then elbows and arms will come out into the shape of a V. And just rest your chest towards the floor. So I'm gonna push this forward a little bit more. My phone. And then the heart is melting towards the floor. You have your head on the bolster, or you can bring it towards the floor if that's better. The second option would be to, you can also use blocks. I find this is a little deeper, so if you have any shoulder injuries, this might be a little too much for the shoulders. And then the third option is just your arms out in a V with the forehead towards the floor.
If it's safe, feels safe in the neck, you can always bring your chin towards the mat. I'm going to go back into my favorite variation with the bolster.
The idea here, and you may need to walk your knees back a little bit, is to keep your, the idea is to keep your hips stacked in the direction over the knees. Now, if this is too much on your shoulders, I know we have all different bodies that are watching this, you can always sink back into child's pose and just rest your arms on top of your blocks or your bolsters or towards the floor. Just allow the upper body to do all the work, the gravity to release deep tension in the shoulders, the front of the chest. If you feel any tingling or pinching or electrical sensation, that just means you might need to back off a little bit. Maybe lean the hips back a touch or widen your arms out into a wider V. That sometimes helps. It could just be you're pressing that nerve bundle in the front of the shoulder. Or you can even bend your elbows slightly. This is the perfect posture to counter the habitual stress in the body from being on a computer a lot, texting, driving, hunching forward in the upper body and the shoulders and the neck. Take five more deep breaths. Bring your awareness and your attention to your forearms. Just start to press down into the prop or the floor with your arms, lifting your head. One hand at a time, slide your hands back underneath the shoulders. And this will feel really good to come into a rounded Halloween shaped cat. So press down through your mat, lift the back of your shoulder blades up, chin towards your chest, and hang out there for at least five breaths. Let your head be like heavy, like a bowling ball. Let it drop down. And slide your hip side to side. Let the body move fluidly. Our next shape we're going to come to is on our belly. So go ahead and come to your belly. I like to bring my hip bones onto the blanket so it's just nice and cushiony for the hips. You can bring a block
out in front of you. And we're just going to rest on the belly first. So bring your elbows out,
rest your forehead down on top of your palms. Just allow the shoulders to relax. Soften the elbows. Completely embodying the sensation again of deep surrender, deep knowing that everything is working out in your advantage. You are always supported as you're being supported by the floor beneath you right now. Start to lift your head
and we'll come into Sphinx pose. Bring your elbows underneath the shoulders and flip the palms face down. Allow your joints to be stacked, so your shoulders are over your elbows, or I like to actually walk the elbows just a touch in front of the shoulders. See how that feels? And then from here, just allow your legs to squeeze together like a tail. So squeeze your legs together. And then just release your legs. So allow the muscles in the legs to totally relax. And let all the sensation be in the target area, which is your lumbar spine. So the lower part of your spine. We want this nice curve in the spine. And you can allow the head to just be neutral and either gaze forward or close your eyes. You can also allow the weight of the head again to feel heavy, so letting it release forward and down. Or maybe you're feeling like you want to support the head. Can bring a block underneath the forehead or a bolster, pillow. And then just start to turn your awareness inward. Letting the meditation be just being, just not doing anything, just being, just letting go. Letting go of the need to complete or do anything.
last few minutes in the shape, you can stay as you are. You can also come down to your belly into that starting point. Or if you want to move on to another deeper layer called seal pose, you would simply just start to straighten your arms, maybe widen your palms out to the edges of your sticky mat. I like to point the fingertips towards the top corners of the mat. Engage the core a little bit, and then see if you can allow the shoulders to draw back. You can allow the shoulders to shrug up into the ears here to support the head and neck. Or maybe it feels better to bring chin in towards the chest, lengthening the back of your neck and spine. And these shapes are just simply to lean into sensation. Really getting in tune with your inner voice, backing off when you need to, or adding on when you need to. Take about 5 more deep breaths in whichever variation you've chosen. Perhaps you find a layer or an edge that brings your body into the deepest connection to surrender. If you're extended in the arms, slowly start to lower your elbows first, coming back to Sphinx pose. And we'll come back down to the belly. It may feel good to bring your arms back towards your hips and rest your left cheek on the mat, or you can again bring your elbows out and rest your cheek on top of your stacked palms, your choice. And just allow this rebound between our next yin posture to feel like you're melting into the floor, melting into sensation of letting go. Start to bring your hands back underneath your shoulders or in that direction.
And we'll make our way onto hands and knees, but slow down your transition, slow down your movements. Find a little freedom in your body, move some energy, move around a bit. Next, we're going to move on to our hips, the target area of the hips. We're going to come into swan pose. So starting from a neutral spine, hands and knees, you'll slide the right knee forward behind the right wrist and then bring the right foot across your mat. Make sure you can see my hip. And then tuck your back toes, so your left toes, and lift that back knee and just kind of lift the knee and slide it back until you find the hips as close to the floor as they're going to come. So they might be pretty high off the mat. That's pretty common. So if that's the case, you have an option of either tucking a pillow or a blanket underneath your right hip, or you can also do a block. So this is just a little bit higher and more sturdy to keep the hips supported. We want the muscle to be able to relax. I'm going to use a blanket. And I like to tuck it pretty far underneath there, so it's underneath my tailbone too. You can also bring a block or a blanket in front of the left hip, and this just allows the hips to stay square so you're not leaning. And then from here, like to stack some props out in front. You can have your bolster, you can tuck blocks underneath your bolster, or you can just use two blocks. I'm going to use my bolster out in front with no blocks, and just stay upright for a moment. Take a deep breath in, allow the hips to settle. Notice in the body if this really hurts your right knee. I want to show you a different variation. You can come down to your back and cross the right ankle over the left thigh and just squeeze the knees in. So you get the same stretch without all that weight on the right knee. So that's a great option. I'm going to come back into my variation of swan here. And then from here, we'll come into sleeping swan from proud swan. So start to come down chest and chin. You can gaze into one direction. It might feel better to have your gaze towards the right or the left. And see if you can really relax the right hip. It takes usually about 30 seconds to a minute for the muscles to relax so that we can get a little deeper into those connective tissues. Remember, the yin practice is embodying the sensation of leaning into a deep release of tension. So if you feel like you're forcing or pushing yourself, then you may need to add more props or back off a little bit. Nice full body scan here. Notice areas that you can relax more, such as the jaw, the eyes, even the space between your fingers and your toes. Support your body here for the last five deep breaths in swan pose. And this is going to feel really juicy and good to come out of the shape. So we'll take our time. A big part of yin is entering and exiting poses slowly. So bring your hands underneath you first. Lift your chest. Find a back bend for about three deep breaths first before we move on. Just lift the chest and let the hips sink into the floor. Roll onto that right hip. You might have to pull your props out from underneath there. And then bring your right leg back with as little effort as possible towards the back of your mat. Just start to find some movements. You can circle out the hip joint. I like to tuck the toes on the floor and just press the heel towards the back of your mat. If you're craving stillness, you can always sink hips back into child's pose. And another really feel good rebound after a long swan pose is downward facing dog. So you can lift your hips if that feels good and just bend one leg and the other. It's good just to take some time between the sides to move around, feel any pulsations of energy moving through. And then we'll come back to that neutral position, hands and knees, tabletop pose, and set up for the left side of swan. Bring your left knee forward. If you're on your back, you can stay there and move into that position. And then go ahead and tuck your back toes, lift your knee, and slide that leg back until you get it to the depth where you want to either prop underneath your left hip or let the left hip move towards the floor. And again, you can set up, you can put props underneath your right hip as well, just to keep the hips square, and that's an option. When you're ready, again, to come down to sleeping swan or passive swan, and maybe gaze in the opposite direction this time. last few minutes here. Make any adjustments so you can deepen the sensation of surrender even more. Okay, and we'll start to make our journey up and out of swan pose. Move as slow as possible, like you're moving through molasses, and just lift the chest. Find a pause here for about 3 deep breaths in your back bend. You can sigh or open mouth exhale. Remove your props from your hip and lean over onto that left hip off of the knee so you can bring the left leg back. You may notice in this practice that it really sparks that sensation of vulnerability, and that is exactly what it's meant to do. And just allow your body to guide you in any rebound for the next minute that feels suitable and appropriate after those 10 minutes of hip opening. From here, we'll start to make our way into a heart opener called fish pose, supportive fish pose. So come to a seat, and you can set up your two blocks. So one will be for the back of the head, and then the other block right across the spine or between the shoulder blades. And for each of us, that's going to feel different. I like it long ways. You can also have it wider across, so horizontally. And a trick of the trade, I like to put a blanket over these, and that makes it a little cushier. You can have your bolster underneath the backs of your knees, or if you're craving a more restorative variation, you can lie back on your bolster as well. So propped up either on the floor or on the blocks. I'm going to use the blocks, though. Have my timer. And might have to lift up a few times just to get yourself in the right position. And then allow the arms to relax out by the sides. Take up space with your legs, let your feet relax. Maybe flip the palms upward. And you can kind of slightly tilt your chin in towards your chest. So the forehead is a little higher than the chin. This helps to really reset the nervous system. This allows the body to really deeply relax. stretch your arms overhead. Maybe even grabbing for opposite elbow or letting the arms cactus. Just a deep opening across the front of the chest. And then begin to roll your way onto either side, your favorite side, whatever side you choose.
Hang out there for a moment in fetal position. I always like to think of the things I'm grateful for when I come into this posture. Maybe the people, animals, the food you're going to eat after. Anything that comes to mind that you can get in tune with that vibration of abundance. And then just press your blocks out from underneath you. And we're going to come into our final pose, which is Shavasana. I'm going to use a bolster underneath the backs of my knees, but you can just stretch your arms long. An important piece of Shavasana is making sure the head is comfortable. So that the body can relax. So if you need, tuck a blanket underneath the back of your neck, your head. Let your arms outstretch away from the sides, palms up. If you have something to cover your eyes, you can do that as well. And take a few moments before you disassociate from your body and just relish in the sensation of deep relaxation after a full practice of yin yoga. Relish in the sensation of deep surrender, letting go.
home and you want to stay here 5, 10, 15 minutes longer, by all means, stay, relax, do you. If you're ready to start to reawaken and move on from your practice, just start to wiggle your toes and your fingers. Bend your knees. Roll to the other side, the opposite side. You rolled to before. And then press your way up to a comfortable seat. Your hands to the tops of your thighs and just flip your palms upward. Chin parallel to the floor. Lengthen the spine. Close your eyes. Just bring your hand, left hand to your heart, right hand to your belly. We'll finish our practice with 3 deep breaths, pranayama breaths. Inhale, open mouth, exhale. Inhale, full breath, full release, exhale out. Deep breath in and release, breath out. Bring your hands to prayer position, bow chin in towards the chest. Allowing this practice to be a tool to let yourself embody the sensation of trust, faith, into surrendering to what is. Namaste.